Sean he chorky and vartins the blint and dahad a hay and dahad a doe, dahad a tree, agus dahad a cah. Agus in shin, a mean man foid na blint an eidig ochto hayan, the vi kiri ar hoir an cahar o crev as a chela uir o wain ele. Kiri, agus u vaile mar shin, ig lehe canish pelle na blint an eidig ochto hayan.
And now, a fanfare to greet the Offaly team. Offaly with the 15 as selected out on the field now, and there was one scary moment there when, as they came out, Martin Furlong took a purler. He skid on the ground there, and let's hope that it's not an indication that the ground has become rather icy like with the rains that we had a few moments ago. And there's Martin going back into his goal. Martin, who showed that he still has all that agility and all the know-how of a goalkeeper by that brilliant penalty save of his in the semi-final against Down. And Richie Connor, or Liam Connor it is there, who's back there with him. And of course the sub-goalkeeper, that's Dennis Wynne with the beard there. And Dennis just tipping the ball out to the right there. And an interesting thing on this Offaly team, there are no less than four sets of brothers. The Connors, the Lowrys, and the Fitzgeralds, who, contrary to reports previously, are brothers. And here come Offaly now, coming up to line up for the photo, and team and subs are going to get into the photograph first of all, after which the subs will go their way and they will remain on the field, just the team themselves. And there you see the variation of the green, white and gold of Offaly. We were, and here come Kerry! Offaly posing for their pictures, team and substitutes, and Sean Lowry there, back there on the left with the moustache. He, of course, one of the big men of the team, and Matt Connor there, we've just passed him, Tomás Connor, Liam Currums, and the team there with their subs, and looking fit, well, and fancied, as they say. Martin Furlong there, and on down to Liam Connor on the left, and now the subs go their way, and now we have the team. Well, here they are, the champions, bidding for four in a row. The fair-haired man out there in the center with the white gloves, Jim Deanahan, who of course is the captain. They're waiting for the arrival of the rest of the team for the photograph. And they are looking for Pat Spillane. They're going to call Pat Spillane over to get in the picture. Over in the dugout on the far side, Joe Cahan is leaning over to try to encourage Pat. Here's Pat, you can see him there on the right, the reluctant hero, as it were. No, he won't come. Last year, Owen Liston, who had an appendix operation, missed this game. But here he comes, and here comes the cheer. Pat Spillane, KO'd from the game at 2 o'clock today. His final test for fitness just didn't come through, and Pat comes out now to take his place amongst his colleagues. No, Kerry are not playing with 16 men. Tommy Doyle replaces Pat, but Pat comes in for the photograph. The stage is truly set. Offaly to complete the double, Kerry to win four in a row. That's the question. Everything set now for the throw-in. Paddy Collins, the referee, just checking his watch. Offaly on the right in the white colours, with the green and gold up on top, and Kerry on the left, the green and the gold shoulders. Portic down, Tomás Connor, and the game is on. Kerry, the first to break away, Sean Walsh. the ball, dithering around there. John Egan passing out now to Tommy Doyle. And Doyle is held, and there is a free for Kerry, about 40 metres out from the Offaly goal. And Mikey Sheehy gone out to take it. Mikey, doubtful early in the week. He got a pain-killing injection before the game. May get another one at half-time. The sharpshooter. He scored a goal and 17 points already in the championship. And Martin Furlong blocks it down. It wasn't going over the bar anyway. And away now, Charlie Conroy. And the ball going very near the sideline. Jerry Carroll brings it over. Jerry Carroll bringing it over there. So there's a line ball for Kerry. Jack O'Shea coming up to take it. Oh, a lovely dangerous ball that. Fisted out by Pat Fitzgerald. Tomás Connor going racing out for it. So also Sean Walsh. Oh! The fair shoulder-to-shoulder strength of the Kerry man there, putting the Offaly man off his feet, shall we say. Sean Walsh now with the line ball, 40 metres out. And in over the heads of backs and forwards, and it's gone wide. Sean Walsh, who sent that ball in, what a powerful shoulder effort that was by him on the taller Tomás Connor there. And this is how they're matched, by the way, that Sean Walsh is playing on Tomás Connor and Tory Dunn on Jack O'Shea. Ball knocked down, and it's Ogie Moran. Ogie's way blocked there, and he's penalised for holding onto the ball too long. He's way blocked there by Richie Connor. Ogie just questioning the referee. Richie Connor's kick. Jack O'Shea doesn't quite hold on to it, and here comes Matt Connor, the first score of the game! The first score of the game! Matt Connor grabbing the ball there, and not even waiting to see where he was going to put it. He knew where he was going to put it, straight over the bar, and there he is, the man who is one of the greatest footballers of our time. He's due a good one, and what a day it would be for Offaly if he picked today to have it. Just almost 3 minutes gone, first half, Offaly 1 point. Kerry, no score. Ball out towards the far side. Tommy Doyle. Mick Fitzgerald, well upfield. Sean Lowry going back for it. He's got inside John O'Keefe. And the ball kicked out over the end line by John O'Keefe defensively. And there's a 45. John there. Chasing Sean Lowry, the best way he could get the ball away from him was to stick out the boot and deflect it out over the end line. And Matt Connor going to take this one as Liam Currums watches anxiously, as does Joe Powell. Matt shot is good into, just gone across the goal mouth. All it needed was a hand. Charlie Nannigan down on the goal now, going to pick his spot in which to place the ball on the corner of the parallelogram.
How did he do?
Shortish one, not a good one. Matt Connor again. And he's been tackled there by Mick Spillane. Connor back out into Pat Fitzgerald. Pat Fitzgerald up into the corner. Tomás Connor's gone up there. But here's Sean Walsh going for it quicker. Referee allows the play go on. He gives the advantage there. Clearance into the centre of the field. Pat Fitzgerald for Offaly. Over to this side of the field. Brendan Lowry going for it. Comes out this side to Aidan O'Halloran, and the referee blows his whistle. No. It was a point, but the referee had blown his whistle long before Aidan O'Halloran had kicked the ball for a foul by Tim Kennelly, and this free will be taken by Matt Connor. Well,
Well, the scoreboard up on the left says 2 points for Offaly. Maybe it's a fortune teller that's working it, I don't know. And there's the kick. The board is right now. Matt Connor, the scorer of both the Offaly points. Offaly 2 points, Kerry no score. And both the points scored by Matt Connor. Charlie Nennigan for the kick out on the 20 metre line. Tommy Doyle going first time for the ball there, and the referee calls for the ball, and it deflected off the referee there, and he's going to throw it in. Tomás Connor on the right, Sean Walsh on the left. Stalemate. Oh dear. Now boys, Tommy Doyle, one of those involved there, the most angry looking of the two. He was retaliating there for a foul. A free to Kerry. Cody O'Shea. A lovely ball. Oh, Liston is inside. He's trying to get room to get rid of the ball. Joe Power blocked there. And away come the Offaly men. Liam Curran's. Brendan Lowry. Ball out now to Cody O'Shea. Cody trying to get inside and he succeeded. And Liam Curran's. Oh dear. He was going to police it going over the end line. Then decided he'd get it himself. Sean Walsh, the ball greasy after the rain. In now to Jack O'Shea. Corrick Dunn pulling out of him, and there's a free for Kerry. And the referee having a word with Corrick Dunn, we won't have any pulling. It wasn't a foul, but it was a foul, if you get what I mean. Mikey Sheehy with the kick. And again, it is dropped short. And again, it goes to Martin Furlong. Out to Aidan O'Halloran, who's way back 13 metres out from the goal. A long clearance upfield. Jim Deanahan coming out. Going back, covering off there. Jack O'Shea. And this is Cody O'Shea. And the ball fisted down by Liam Connor. Tomás Connor not having a very happy time out in the centre of the field. Corrick Dunn getting the ball up into his hand. And nicely fielded by Matt Connor. Cody Lynch after him. Matt feeding the wing. Oh, this is blackboard stuff, this is. And Sean Lowry's kick is in. It's hit the upright. Brendan Lowry. Jerry Carroll wide. Well, there's no doubt in the world that the backroom boys have been working with Offaly. And anybody who thought that this game was going to be a cakewalk, think again. The score, Offaly 2 points, Kerry no score. And there is the effort, but it went wide. Still 2 points for Offaly, no score for Kerry. And Aidan O'Halloran out over the line. Line ball for Kerry. Cody. There's no doubt in the world that the Kerry dressing room weren't short of imprecation before they came out. Cody O'Shea. Owen Liston. What the pass intercepted there by Liam Connor. Oh, lovely effort there. Matt Connor out now to Aidan O'Halloran. O'Halloran into Connor, who slips. And now it's Kerry coming away. Cody O'Shea. Trying for an open space. Owen Liston in search of the ball. Coming down to the centre of the field. And here come the Kerry men now. Into the attack as Tommy Doyle moves it up. Ger Power gone across to the far side. Trying to get past Liam Curran's. Tommy Doyle again. Into the centre now to Ogie Moran. Ogie's shot is good, and it's the first Kerry score. Here it is again into Ogie Moran. He almost let it get away. It didn't, and it's over the bar. 2 points to one in favour of Offaly after almost 10 minutes of play in this first half. and some delightful touches of football up to now. Martin Furlong. And Pat Fitzgerald couldn't hold on to it. And there is a free as Shawnee Walsh has turned upsy-downsy. Free taken by Mick Spillane. Oh dear, on Liston. And Martin Furlong passing out a nicely placed clearance to Pat Fitzgerald, Vincent Henry. And now here come the Kerry men again. Ger Power into the center. And the shot is high, the shot is over the bar. And that is the equalizer. Here it is again. Comes out to Paddy O'Shea. He shakes off a tackle, takes his kick, and it is 2 points apiece. About 11 minutes gone in this first half. The look of satisfaction on a face that had a look of anxiety before the game started. Martin Furlong, Owen Liston in the foreground there. He's not standing quite as close to it as it would look there. Foreclosure. Long kick. This is Charlie Conroy. Sidesteps Ger Power. Sean Lowry. And Vincent Henry being tackled there by Michael Spillane. Still Vincent Henry. And the referee waves on the play as Sean Walsh clears that ball out. And that's Sean Lowry, the full forward. This is Pádraig Dunn. And there waiting for the ball is Paddy O'Shea into that wide open space out there, now filled by Owen Liston. And catching the ball with all the confidence in the world, the youngest man on the field, Pádraig Dunn, but he's kicked well blocked down. And the referee has awarded a free to Kerry, the reception of which you can hear. Michael Spillane to take it, just outside the 45-meter line. And the referee awards another free to Kerry here for a foul by Charlie Conroy there on Mikey Sheehy as he was going for the ball, and this could be the Kerry lead. Mikey Sheehy's kick, it's over the bar, and Kerry lead for the first time. And there is the shot, there's the angle, and there's the point. 13 minutes gone, and the score, Kerry 3 points, Offaly 2. And Mikey Sheehy, I wonder, is he limping just a little bit? In fact, he is. Kick out by Martin Furlong. And Kerry playing a lot better in the last 3 or 4 minutes than they did early on. Jack O'Shea up the field now. And this Paddy O'Shea, he is everywhere. Owen Liston into the Paddy O'Shea again. And Paddy, a right half back, took that one from a left full forward position. And getting out to the ball is Ger Power very nicely. And Ger Power shouldered down, as was the Offaly man earlier. It was Richie Connor that did it. That's John Egan shot, and it's gone wide. John Egan getting the ball from the break there, took his shot quickly, but it went wide. Kerry 3 points, Offaly 2. Ger Power top of the right, Mikey Sheehy right half forward. And the free quickly taken, too quickly taken. The referee wasn't even looking. He was having a word with somebody else. And there is a free to Kerry to be taken by Jack O'Shea. Mick Fitzgerald Tomás Connor trying to get out to it, but not really getting in the hunt at all. And this is Owen Liston trying to get past Liam Connor, and he takes his shot as he's grounded there. And just watch this. Watch this for quick action that just didn't quite come off. It deserved to come off, but it didn't. 3 points for Kerry, 2 for Offaly. Owen not having as yet the dominance that Kerry would like him to have in there, as Liam Connor keeps watching him everywhere he goes. Vincent Henry got down there by Michael Spillane, and the ball coming up now to this side of the field and going back towards the end line, out over the end line, and in fact gone wide. Tim Kennelly, in fact, was back there in action just a moment ago, not Michael Spillane, as I said. And Mikey Sheehy and Liam Curran's. Liam Curran's has gone back to left full back, and Charlie Conroy has come out to half forward, while Mikey Sheehy has gone back into where he was before. And this Paddy O'Shea, he's everywhere. And this is John Egan. And Owen Liston, I don't know how he got that one, but he did. And a free for a shoulder or push in the back there. And that free will be taken almost over on the sideline there. Mick Fitzgerald to take it. Tomás Connor into the center now, and a long attacking ball by Aidan O'Halloran, and Sean Lowry trying to do Jimmy Deenan going back for it. Sean Lowry trying to do an own listen with a deflection ball there that nearly came off for him. And the referee awarding a free to Kerry for a push in the back there by Pat Fitzgerald, and this free about 35 metres, a little bit less than 35 metres out from the Kerry goal. And Paddy Lynch is going to take it. Short one into Tim Kennelly. Out now to John Egan. And it's gone too far. It's gone too far. And, well, it was brought out by an Offaly man's boot. It looked for a moment as if there was going to be a free out, but no, it is brought out, and it is a 45. Kerry leading 3 points to 2. Jack O'Shea. Got by John Egan. And deflected over the bar by Mikey Sheehy. Mikey Sheehy, limp or no limp, went in for that one. Here it is again. And deflected from just in front of the goal, over the bar for a point. 4 points to 2 in favour of Kerry, and I'm sure there are Offaly people who will wonder just where Mikey was when he deflected that one over the bar. 4-2. And the great jizz that was in the early stages of the game has, well, eased off for the moment anyway. We've about almost 19 minutes gone. Pat Fitzgerald, but the ball kicked back up by Michael Spillane into the centre of the field now. Richie Connor out now to Aidan O'Halloran. All Offaly at this stage. And there are two Kerry men back there. One of them is in possession. It's Paddy Lynch. And now Offaly coming back into the attack. High lobbing ball in there again. And Jack O'Shea in, helping the defence. Out to Paddy O'Shea. This is Owen Liston and Liam Connor alongside him. This is Jer Power. And Jer racing up. And look at Liam Curran's go after him. hoppity, hoppity into the goal, and it's got by Martin Furlong. His pass isn't a good one. Tommy Doyle, high, and his shot certainly isn't a good one. Here it is again. And the final shot just screwing off the boot and going so wide. Tommy Doyle, who came on last minute for Pat Spillane, and the score, Kerry 4 points, Offaly 2. And Owen Liston, who is certainly having a tight time of it with Liam Connor. Liam, who is a brother of Tomás in the center of the field, and Richie, a brother of Matt, who's playing at top of the right. Corrick Dunn. Michael Spillane. Cody Lynch. Now Tomás Connor in the center of the field. And I don't know who was supposed to be doubtful starters, but Tomás certainly hasn't got going today, whether it's the injured leg or what. Owen Liston, Liam Connor together. This is Liam Currans. And there seems to be a lot of open space back there for the Kerry defence to take over as Tim Kennelly clears out. Going, gone. Well, John would have wanted one of those things in the background to catch that one. Pat Fitzgerald, and standing all alone is Sean Walsh. Owen Liston. Up the wing, and Jair Power running onto it. Liam Currans after him, trying to block his way, and it's a point. Jair Power getting it, racing away, taking the pass from Owen Liston, racing away, shaking off Liam Currans and sending it over, making it 5 points for Kerry, 2 points for Offaly after about 22 minutes of play in this first half. And Offaly playing with the breeze in this first half. Jerry Carroll not getting it, however. Oh, very nice bit of play there by Mikey Sheehy, but the pass went wrong. Pat Fitzgerald. And a line ball far side of the field for Kerry. Or for Offaly, I should say. And it's to be taken by Pat Fitzgerald. And it goes to Pat Dunn, back out now to Matt Connor. A lovely testing ball, and the ball deflected out over the line. And indeed, I'm sure there are Kerry people who are wondering where the Offaly forward was when that ball dropped down very close to the parallelogram. It's a 45 for Offaly, to be taken by Matt Connor. He's got the only two Offaly points so far. No, it's gone wide, and the score remains 5 points for Kerry, 2 points for Offaly. And the great zing and zest of the first 5 to 10 minutes by Offaly has somewhat withered away at this stage. Still very much in touch, however, as Kerry lead by these 3 points. Once again, Kerry winning it around the centre of the field, but a free for a push in the back there, and this free to be taken by Richie Connor from 65 metres out from the Kerry goal. Sean Lowry and John O'Keefe together. Sean Lowry getting it. Sean Lowry taking his shot and sending it over the bar. Very cool, very calm, and very accurate, making it 5-3 in favour of Kerry, as Sean Lowry got that ball, beat John O'Keefe to it, turned, made his angle, took his shot, and here it is again. And back now to Charlie Nelligan, placing the ball for the kick out after that one. Just about 10 minutes left in this first half. Bursting in there to get the ball is Doyle, Tom Doyle. Now this is John Egan. That's Owen Liston. And that's Liam Connor, the fullback, breaking up the attack and sending it well down. Little bit of fortune telling going wrong there. Cody Lynch getting it up now to Sean Walsh. Nice bit of feeling there by Pádraig Dunn. John O'Keefe, Tom Doyle, John Egan, Tom Doyle, Joe Carr. Joe Carr waking his way in now, but Joe sending it wide, and a few of the forwards with their hand. Here it is again. He's coming through, he takes his shot and he sends it wide, and a few of the forwards standing inside, not altogether happy that Joe decided to go it alone. 5 points for Kerry, 3 points for Offaly. Five wides for Kerry, 4 wides for Offaly. Pádraig Dunn almost did, he did a clever thing, almost had the good reaction. Owen Liston foul there. Free to be taken by Mikey Sheehy. And Offaly have made the anticipated switch of Jerry Carroll gone centre field and Tomás Connor centre half forward. This is Mikey Sheehy. And that one has gone wide, and the score remains 5 points for Kerry, 3 points for Offaly. And Mikey looking just to see what happened. Remember, doubtful until a couple of days ago because of an injured foot, and playing today with a pain-killing injection before the game. And certainly the usually accurate Mikey has not been on the ball so far today. This is Jack O'Shea. And it's gone out over the line. There's a lot of the anxiety seems to have gone out of the game. It seems to have gone into a valley at the moment. And the Kerry dugout over there, nobody looking particularly excited or even particularly anxious, not even little Leo Griffin. And this is Tomás Connor. And a very short pass there to Aidan O'Halloran. Aidan's got a knock. Richie Connor. Liam Curran's. There's a dangerous ball. Nice. The held in there by Matt Connor. Out to Sean Lowry. Matt Connor getting it up. And the referee is awarding a free out. He's awarding a free out. Here it is again. There's Matt Connor getting the ball up. And he's been penalized for carrying the ball too far. Certainly he could have fingerprints on him, that's for sure. 5 points to 3 in favour of Kerry, and they are attending now to Aidan O'Halloran, who got a knock there when he went down. It was a boot going to the ball there, but it got to Aidan's head beforehand. Got a knock on the side of the head and being attended to. Seems to be all right. Yes, he takes his position. He certainly looks a shaken man, but maybe the run for the first ball will make him feel that bit better. A lovely bit of feeling there by Pádraig Dunn. But this one gone out to the right, gone out over the end line and wide. Make it about 6 minutes left in this first half, but Kerry leading by 2 points. There's a man who's certainly been blazing a trail in the attack, Ger Power, although that last shot of his, it won't go into his book of things I like to remember. And Pádraig Dunn, who seemed to be ploughing a lone furrow there in the center of the field. And this is Charlie Conroy, over on the far side of the field now. Getting the ball upfield, John O'Keefe and Sean Lowry, Aidan O'Halloran. Aidan's shot is just to the left and it has gone wide. Just looking round now to see what switches have been made back here. it looks as if John Egan is now top of the right and Mick Fitzgerald has moved with them. And Mikey Sheehy is top of the left, and gone after him is Charlie Conroy. That's the fullback, full forward position. There's Mikey and Charlie Conroy with them. Well, a lot of loose, scrappy play there. Tim Kennelly putting his own Liston into position and possession. Into the center now, and that's John Egan. Coming out to Ogie Moran. Ogie's shot goes in, but Liam Connor is there. That's Vincent Henry. He's pushed in the back, and there's a free. A free for Offaly, well inside their own 45-meter line. Pat Fitzgerald to take it, a shortish, well-placed one. Aidan O'Halloran. And the ball going back over, and goes back over the backs and the forwards. A nice pass, brother to brother, Sean to Brendan Lowry. I'm not too sure where that one was supposed to go, but I don't think it was there. And Brendan looks the way he nodded, as if he agreed. 5 points to three in favour of Kerry, as we now have about 3 to 4 minutes, about 3 minutes or so left in this first half. The sun, thankfully, blazing down now. An autumnal nip in the air as the ball drops into the centre of the field. And again, it's Pádraig Dunne. If only he had somebody with him, he'd certainly be doing great work out there. Brendan Lowry. Lowry's kick is high, and it's gone over the bar. A point there. Brendan Lowry getting that one. The ball coming from Pádraig Dunne, who is really playing a great game in the centre of the field. Coming in now, there's Pádraig's pass over. Comes across now to Brendan Lowry. Jimmy Deanahan is after him, but Brendan gets his kick in, and now there's only 1 point between them, and the crowd beginning to wake up again. 5 points to four in favour of Kerry, and we have less than 3 minutes left in this first half. And the ball blocked down there. Joe Power gets it. Mick Fitzgerald to Pat. Pat in possession. Passes the ball in now to Mick, back out to Pat. The Fitzgeralds are having a ball, and now it's Sean Walsh. A dangerous hopping ball with all listed in position. A great save! A great save by Martin Furlong. You don't do that every day of the week. Charlie Connor, here is the save. There's the shot, and there's the save, and here's the action. It is the Offaly attack right in gear again. Out to Tomás Connor. Tomás steadies himself. He takes his shot, and there goes the equaliser. A lovely shot there by Tomás Connor, coming right back into the game. A save at one end of the field by Martin Furlong. A point at the other by Tomás Connor. The sides are level at 5 points apiece. About a minute and a bit left in this first half. And certainly the scoreboard now making for an enthralling second half. Kick out by Charlie Nettigan. And Pádraig Dunne beaten this time by Sean Walsh. What a lovely catch by Sean. Charlie Conroy and Mikey Sheehy. Aidan O'Halloran and Ger Power. The Offaly man getting it in. Brendan Lowry. Nicely blocked down. This is Matt Connor. Matt's shot into the goal mouth, and Charlie Nettigan watches it go whizzing by. We're in the final minute of the first half now. The sides are level. A first half that started with fine football, went to sleep for about 10 minutes or 15 minutes, but suddenly has come back again. Both sides playing some excellent football. An overhead swing there by Mick Spillane. This is Tom Doyle, and it is a line ball for Offaly. Tom pleading that he was pushed over the line. Nice kick Jimmy Deanahan all alone. The Paddy O'Shea. And Brendan Lowry has gone down injured up the field here. Paddy O'Shea with the ball. This man having the game of his life. And that's saying something. Still Paddy O'Shea. But the pass goes astray. And Charlie Conroy comes in to make a mockery of it all from the Kerry point of view. Paddy Lynch out now to Sean Walsh. And still injured up the other end of the field is Brendan Lowry. And the referee has blown his whistle. And it is half time. They're playing away up here, but the referee has signaled that it is half-time, and Brendan Lowry, who was injured in a clash with Jimmy Deanahan, has gone down injured and is still injured up on the left corner up here. They're attending to him down here. His brother Sean with him, but the team's going off the field, and exactly what the booing is for as the teams go off, I'm not too sure, but there they are. The men from Offaly, the men from Kerry, they go to the dressing room, 5 points each at half time. Trouble there a moment ago. Ball in the center of the field. Ger Power, the score still 5 points apiece. This is Pat Fitzgerald. And John O'Keefe beaten to the ball by Sean Lowry. And Michael Spillane in there with Sean Lowry. Pat Fitzgerald. Pádraig Dunn. And Pádraig Dunn threw the ball, there's no doubt about that. And there's a free out for Kerry from about 20 metres out from their own goal, or a little bit more. 5 points apiece is the score, and we're in the early stages of this second half. Charlie Nelligan. Ball breaking to Aidan O'Halloran. Brendan Lowry coming down for it. He's pushed in the back by Jimmy Deanahan and a quickly taken free. And here come the Offaly men. Still going through. And the shot that hit the crossbar by Jerry Carroll there. Hit the crossbar and came back into play. And there it is again coming out. And here's the live action. As John Egan gets the ball in behind his man, but back goes Mick Fitzgerald. This is Richie Connor. And Michael Spillane going for it, but the ball gone off of Vincent Henry, in fact kicked by Vincent Henry out over the sideline. Michael Spillane. Richie Connor. A change of mind at least once. And now he's changed it the third time by carrying the ball too far. Carried the ball too far, and they're playing away, but the referee has blown his whistle and awarded a free to Kerry just about 60 metres out from the Offaly goal. Jack O'Shea. Nice ball, hopping out for Owen Liston, coming out to it. And the passing movements go on. A high ball from Sean Walsh, and it's over the bar. Over the bar for the lead for Kerry. Sean Walsh sending that one over after almost 4 minutes of play, and the score is Kerry 6 points, Offaly 5. Kerry playing with the wind in this second half. Martin Furlong getting ready with the kick out. And once again, Sean Walsh in the centre of the field. Charlie Conroy, he couldn't hold on to it. And here come Kerry, Ger Power. Liam Curran is after him. Owen Liston back into the centre, and the shot that has gone wide. The shot there that went wide as Mikey Sheehy went running in to grab it, and it just barely went wide, but wide it went. Still 6-5 in favour of Kerry. Here it is. There's the shot, and just wide. And the kick out to the centre of the field. Tádhg Dunn, who's certainly the youngest man on the field and certainly having a great game. That's Paddy Lynch. That's Paddy O'Shea. That's Owen Liston. Liam Connor coming after him. Liam saying thank you very much, Owen. That doesn't happen very often. And the ball gone off Jerry Carroll. Line ball for Kerry. Jack O'Shea, in that line on which the ball is placed is the 65-meter line. John Egan, Mick Fitzgerald. Aidan O'Halloran coming in. Richie Connor, Pat Fitzgerald, and Kerry seem to have loose men all over the place up there. Tim Kennelly, Ger Power, and Liam Curran's. Tomás Connor gone back for it. And the pass, not a very well-placed one. And away now come Offaly with Aidan O'Halloran. And that pass, not a very well-placed one. Tim Kennelly, that pass, a well-placed one. Jack O'Shea, John Egan. And the ball coming to Mikey Sheehy, coming across from the far side. No, there's a tail on it, it's gone wide. And the score remains 6-5 in favour of Kerry, a low-scoring game up to now. Martin Furlong. Mick Fitzgerald. Jerry Carroll and Tim Kennelly going for it. Big Tim gets there. And the referee penalises them for a foul pass. A free to Offaly from the 45-metre line. And it's to be taken by Pat Fitzgerald just outside the 45-metre line. And nicely fielded by John O'Keefe. Across now to Jack O'Shea. Mikey Sheehy. And the ball sent over the sideline, line ball. And it's about 10 metres out from the Offaly goal. And it's a Kerry ball. Owen Liston. And the high ball that's gone over the bar. Over the bar there for a point, increasing the Kerry lead now to 7-5 as John Egan got that one and sent it over from an awkward angle. 7-5, the score. And about 8 minutes gone in the second half, and it's beginning to rain. Sean Walsh lording it in the catching department at the moment. Referee has blown his whistle and awards a free against Offaly for holding. Paddy O'Shea, who was everywhere for the first 20 minutes of the game, placing this one just inside the Offaly 65. And a great block now. I don't know how it happened. It's gone out. Here it is again. Let's see how it happened. Down it came, and and a block shot there by Mick Fitzgerald, I think it was, that got his foot out there and deflected the ball around the goal over the line for a 65, and certainly it had goal written all over it. Mikey Sheehy placing the ball on the 45-meter line. And the kick blocked down, and the referee has penalized the Offaly man for standing too near. So it is another kick. And again, it's Mikey Sheehy. Mikey's kick is straight over the bar, no doubt whatever about it. And although he was limping a bit early on, the limp seems to have eased out quite a bit as Kerry lead 8 points to 5. About 9 minutes gone in this second half. Martin Furlong's kick to the center of the field. Nice feed in there by Jack O'Shea. And the referee awards another free to Kerry inside the 65-meter line. Paddy O'Shea to take it. Owen Liston gone out intending to flick that one in, but it's flicked out to the corner. Ger Power into Paddy. Paddy O'Shea. Tip back to Jack O'Shea. There's a terrific tussle in the goal mouth, and the referee has awarded a free out from the parallelogram. And here is what the schmozzle was all about. There was a fair amount of pulling and dragging in there. Free out. Tomás Connor. Brendan Lowry, Jimmy Deanahan still after him. This is Richie Connor. Pat Fitzgerald, can he get there? No, he can't. I wonder, would Offaly gamble by putting in Johnny Mooney at this stage, although Johnny not 100% fit. I just wonder. It's a passing thought. Mitch Pilar. Lovely bit of feeling there by Richie Connor. Tomás Connor going out for it, but he's beaten to the run by Ger Power. Back to Jimmy Deanahan. And the referee calling for the ball. Referee calling for the ball, and here comes a sub. It is number 24, Johnny Mooney, and so help me God, I didn't see him coming on the far side of the field a couple of minutes ago. Tomás Connor, I think, is going off, and his place taken by Johnny Mooney, who would have been on the team, but for an injury that he incurred at work some time ago. Line ball taken and sent wide. The score remains 8 points to 5 in favour of Kerry, and in spite of the closeness of the game, as far as the scores are concerned, the electricity isn't quite what it was in the early stages. And here's a man who was full of electricity early on, but at the moment, not so much. Ball out to the center of the field, Pat Fitzgerald. Brendan Lowry. Gone up outside him. To get the ball is Liam Collins. Still Liam Collins. Liam takes what one could loosely describe as a shot, but it kicks it right across the field, out over the sideline. Line ball for Kerry, about 5 metres from the end line. Just the announcement over the public address that Johnny Mooney has come on. And Johnny Moody gets his fist to it out to the far side of the field. Brendan Lowry gone out after it. Still Brendan Lowry and Jimmy Deanahan. Referee penalises Jimmy. Free for Offaly. 40 metres out from the Kerry goal, far side of the field, Matt Connor gone over to get it. Gets it, places it, and is about to take it. And Matt sends it wide. Score, Kerry 8 points, Offaly 5. 3 points between them, and that would have been a very useful one for Offaly. And if you're checking the wides, they're 9 for Kerry, 9 for Offaly. No goals so far in this game. Cody O'Shea tackled after the ball was gone by Johnny Mooney, and a free for Kerry where the ball lands. And that is about 50 metres out from the goal. Tommy Doyle with it now, fisting it up towards the corner. Look at Mikey Sheehy, the way he runs. Look at Charlie Conroy, the way he robs. Oh dear. Don't look at Paddy O'Shea, the way he shoots. 8 points for Kerry, 3 points for Offaly. 8-5, I should say. 8-5, 3 points between them. 3 points between them. And the rain just drizzly at the moment. Ogie Moran, who has moved on to the left half position with the Tom Doyle gone into the centre. And Pádraig Dunn, another bit of high fielding in the centre of the field. And this is Paddy Lynch, who is moving outfield. Pádraig Dunn again. And out over the sideline, line ball for Kerry. That ball, quite breezy. This is Mick Spillane, brother of Pat, and Tom, of course, who's in the subs bench. Oh, a lovely bit of hurling-like passing there by Owen Liston. No, gone wide. A lovely swing there, adding to the ball as a hurler might, but it just got to the line before John Egan. Martin Furlong once again. And from the break, it's Ogie Moran. Mikey Sheehy, Paddy O'Shea, and Paddy sends it wide. You know, these sallies of Paddy's up to attack, I'm sure some of the mentors are almost wishing he'd stay where he was and not shoot, but he is one great player. Charlie Nelligan calling to him to come back, because he can see a wide open space back there over on the far wing. Vincent Henry, top of the right, and Mick Spillane, left half back. In fact, players playing everywhere back here now. Ogie Moran, Sean Walsh, Owen Liston, and Liam Connor. Very nicely dropped by Owen before he went over the sideline. Mikey Sheehy in there, but so also Liam Connor. Oh, right across the goal, and racing to save from going over the sideline on the end line is Pádraig Dunn. And he won. Up now to Aidan O'Halloran. Johnny Mooney. Richie Connor. And the ball fisted further up the field. John O'Keefe going back for it. And John slipping there. Nobody too close to him, and he did it. Ball cleared out by him. Ger Power. Still Ger Power. Still Ger Power, but blocked now by Johnny Mooney. Back to Jack O'Shea, and the ball hopping harmlessly out over the end line and wide. Momentary confrontation there in the centre of the field. Referee having a word one way or the other with Ger Power. 8 points to 5. We haven't had a score for quite a while. shot for 9 minutes. Well, up at this end of the field, they're waiting for action. The action down the other end, and here it is. Jack O'Shea making his mind up to go before anybody else did. Sean Walsh, a shot and a wide. Well, Kerry, you're certainly squandering away an awful lot of chances, and they have now had 14 wides, and Offaly have had 9. Then, of course, they've had 8 points, and Offaly have had 5.